Hey, what's up guys, this is Daddy Cool and you are watching Satisfactory with the subtitle Megafactory Online. Now in previous episode I have created a lot of things to reach this position in the game. I mean, this whole area has been created in the previous episode. Part of it was shown in a timelapse video. If you feel like, just check episode 4, it's in the beginning area. And the other half, I mean the top side of this factory, has been created during the episode. Now there are a couple of things going on. I am creating rotors and reinforced iron plates, and on the top side I am already producing steel ingots and steel tubes. So we are starting to grow, starting to create more and more complex things for the factory. Now for this episode I am planning to fully reach proper efficiency for the top side. I am still missing 60 pieces of iron ore per minute, and I have to get that from somewhere. And I am not sure about the coal production. I mean, I'm using it for steel, but maybe during this episode I will create some kind of a coal and water combination for electricity production, but that's not really sure. So these are the plans. Let's see how this works out. And before I do anything, I can again create an upgrade. Let's just fulfill these things, the jump pad and the UGL landing pad, because they are pretty easy to fulfill, but I do not really plan to create those things. Let's just finish this mission.
Milestone reached. The Fix-It jump pad combines high technology and innovation for optimized factory traversal and an ideal travel experience. Clarification: ideal travel experience not guaranteed, individual results may vary. Pioneers are responsible for all workplace accidents resulting from jump pad usage.
Yeah, I'm not gonna test that thing. Okay. So let's just check for this iron. Oh, it's there. Okay, 200 meters, probably near that rock. Let's take some electricity with us, and I'm gonna mine those resources there. Let's just start it. The sulfur. Yeah. Electricity, come with me. And probably there is the resource I was coming to. There you go. What do we have here and there? That's sulfur. I'm gonna pick the sulfur up and harvest this fruit. Yeah, let's just mine it. Okay. And what's that? There's something on top of that thing, and here is something of an interest. Yeah, it's nothing possible in here. Let's try to check this area around. Well, can I go up? Oh, it seems I can. Probably that's the way. Yeah, that's good. Okay. Oh, modular frames. Oops, didn't want to jump down. Here we go, some reinforced iron plates and a couple of more. Concrete. That's good. Can I open it? Yeah. So it seems. And there's a hard drive. Taken.
Damaged hard drive successfully acquired. All pioneers are contractually obliged to preserve and secure any recovered hard drives for analysis in the MAM, which may result in benefits to the Fix-It mission. Speculation as to why there are crashed freighters in your Fix-It designated zone is discouraged as specified in your contract.
Oh, this animal is a little bit bigger and harder than the previous ones. I cannot pick that up. Okay, I had to sort things out. And what's this? There is something of an interest in there. I don't think I can get in there just yet. Let's put a marker here. Yeah, like that. I have to blow it up, I suppose. And there are a couple of more enemies. Let's check the sword thing. What is the efficiency? What? They are running away. One is down. Where's the other one? I don't see the other one. Whoa, disappeared, I suppose. Okay. Let's mine this sulfur. And let's check the quality of this iron source really fast. What can we expect here? Transport jump pad, loading pad. Okay, I'm not gonna try that out. So miner goes here. 120 pieces. Wow, that's really good for a reason. I mean, if you remember in previous episode, I was a little bit struggling with iron ore because here's the enemy. I thought I was, I stuck him, but no. Okay, so iron ore is coming. So what I was trying to tell that in previous episode, there is another iron source, which is generating 120 pieces. And actually, only 60 pieces of iron ore is being produced into iron rods, and the other 60 pieces, I am low on reinforced iron plate in the meantime, so the other 60 pieces is being transferred into the steel production, and I'm missing their 60 pieces. So it was a, I don't know how to express myself in this case, so it's not efficient at the moment. But now I found another iron source with 120 pieces per minute delivery, and if I feed it into that line, I will be able to more or less put it into 100% efficiency, which is really good. Now the big question is how to make that, how to connect and take it there, but I think I have something in mind for that. I'm gonna put here a platform like that. Okay, let's climb up there. Maybe I put this into here. Like that, and I can climb up from this side. That's good. And in this case, I'm gonna put this into here. And let's make it a little bit higher. Now connect those things. That's good. And what to do here is the question. I'm gonna deconstruct this belt. And put this into here. Now I connect them up because I'm not sure what will be built under this area, but like this it's working well. So I have an unused 60 pieces of iron ore capacity in there, and 60 pieces of coal also unused capacity there. Maybe I will just take it to here and produce some steel. Yeah, probably that's a good idea. And we have the productions in here. So let's go back to the hub and check that thing. I mean the hard drives. Oh, here we go. Hard drives. Hard drive scan. That's okay. 10 minutes. Whoa. I'm not gonna wait it there. Let's sort. Put things in. Okay, I have a lot of iron ore in hand. So, tier 3, let's unlock this tractor, truck station and inventory slots, because sooner or later I will unlock everything from this list. And I'm missing a couple of iron plates, not the cables. Let's sort, take the iron plates. Sort. Yeah, my stocks are getting lower and lower. That's not really good. So put the iron plates there and launch.
Milestone reached. Tractors permit pioneers to move around the world in a manner similar to using legs, except with wheels and the rampant consumption of natural resources. They can also be automated to self-drive and deliver resources between truck stations, which in turn facilitate automation of loading, unloading, and refueling.
Okay. Maybe we will use it a little bit later, but not just yet. So the next thing I would like to unlock is the blueprints, which unlocks the upgrade blueprints, so blueprint gun. And the blueprint designer, that's really good. And I'm gonna need steel beams, but it's not steel ingots. Okay, this is produced in the constructor. Oh, I've got it now. So I have to create constructor. And the steel ingots are turned into steel beams. So let's check the output here. It's 45. So 120 pieces of ingots are coming out. And I am using up 60 for this production. So I have a capacity of 60 pieces. Let's check this constructor here really fast. Feeding is from that side, from the back. Like this. Let's check, start with something else. Let's put a splitter. Yeah. Going that direction, maybe here, and constructor, no, like this, yeah. So you're gonna produce the steel beams, 60 ingots turned into 15 beams. Well, this will use up or the resources, but let's plan ahead. I'm gonna put a splitter into here. So, not merger, splitter. What's the input? Yeah, like that. Create pack, create pack. And oh, it's not good. I have to change the direction of that. Merger, splitter. Yeah, like this. So now it should be working correctly. I need to give electricity for that. That's the thing we are missing here. There you go. There you go. And hopefully it's working. I mean, it doesn't. Oh, it's steel ingot, and you need steel ingot. What's the problem? It's not working for some reasons. Deconstruct. Deconstruct. And let's do it once more. Sometimes it's just not working, although everything seems to be working fine. So maybe now, oh yeah, it's working already. And you are producing the steel beams. Okay, where should I collect you? That's the big question here. I'm gonna place another machine here, just in case. I'm not sure how I will feed it just yet, but sooner or later I have to solve it. And let's create a logistics container into here. Like that. Here I'm gonna put a merger. Yeah, and products coming to here. And another merger. There. Okay, and connect things together. Okay, electricity. We are missing the cables from the constructor. There you go. Let's set this into steel beams. But I think I'm just not gonna feed it yet. Yeah, a little bit later. Or maybe not. Whatever, we stay. We keep it like this, and later we will check what is the situation with that. So let's feed a couple of things here that I can. The cables. Take some cables. Concrete. I might have to make a trip. Oh, I have 100 more reinforced iron plates on hand. So I might have to take a trip to the other side of this factory area. Yeah, probably that's the thing to do. Feed those there. I'm gonna store a couple of things here. Like those. Yeah, all of those. Those as well. Because I have copper wire and cable production at the other side of the map, and I want to collect those, also the concrete, which I am missing at the moment for the milestone. So let's gather those things just really fast. Oh, this is also almost full. So let's check these. I have not visited them for a while now. Wow, okay. Now it's really good. And the thing is that I think I can put these produced resources into this awesome machine. Yeah, like that. Couple of cables. And it seems I have upgraded my sword. Enemies has also been upgraded. Or maybe not, because this was easier. MAM research is complete. I'm gonna take the cables. I mean, put the cables first in. And take a couple of more. That seems to be a good idea. And there we go. That's okay. Now it has enough space for production. And let's check this hard drive research, and also fill a couple of things into the objectives, the milestone. Where are you? Here we go. Let's give the resources I was going for. Yeah, that's it. Let's put a couple of things into here. Not here, maybe here. A couple of resources go there. There we go. Very good. Now it's fine. And let's check this.
Hard drive analysis completed. Alternative recipe selection available in the MAM.
Mm-hmm. What's the alternative selection? I'm not really sure. Not here, not here. Nothing in here. Quartz, sulfur. Okay. Maybe we will find it out sooner or later. Now there's one thing I can do here, and that's the power shard, which can be created from the blue slugs. And I think I can create this power slug thing. Yeah, the overclocking. Let's just search that.
Overclocking development completed. Power shards can now be inserted into all buildings to increase input and output speed. Underclocking is also possible. Note, power consumption of overclocked buildings increases exponentially.
Okay, I'm gonna take a couple of iron rods. And I have only a few portable miners in hand, so let's just create a couple of those. Maybe I'm gonna build this up to 10 pieces. Yeah, 7, 8, 9, 10 pieces, that's good. Let's check how many modular frames do I have. I suppose it's not much. No, it's... it's really not bad. Almost 100 pieces. Right? Let's just check it. Yeah, we have the 100 pieces. So the question is, steel beams. I'm not really sure that production of steel beams were that fast. No, it's more or less okay, 125. Okay, so the question is, what should we do till the steam beams are being produced? Let's check the other milestones, I suppose. So logistics MK3, industrial storage container. Okay, so I suppose that's a bigger storage container with double input, double output or something like that. Conveyor belt MK3, that's also good. Conveyor lift and stackable pipeline support. And I am producing already the steel pipe, so that's okay. Reinforced iron plates. I think I will have enough of that by the time I can unlock this. And steel beams, that's also good. So advanced steel production. Okay. Requirements probably fulfillable. This one as well. And I need 500 copper sheets for hyper tubes. And copper sheet I have not done yet, but I think I can. So let's just do this, I think. So copper sheets, let's climb up here. And oh yeah, it's a little bit filled here already. I'm gonna check what is the copper sheet requirement. Not in here, maybe in this constructor. Recipes, copper sheet. So 20 pieces of copper ingots are created into 10 pieces of copper sheets. So normally 60 pieces of copper ingots is something that we can work with. It's normal ore, or maybe less. We will see how this works out. Let's look for copper. Meters, 300 meters. Let's check this source. So this one is impure. And if it's impure, it's 30 pieces per minute. I'm gonna check this other one. It's not really close. There we go. And I did not take electricity with me, but anyway, it's gonna be sold. Okay, killed. Impure. So this means I'm gonna put a mine in here. Yeah, like that. Impure is 30 pieces. And I think I have enough iron plates in hand. And we're gonna merge it with the other impure source, and that's gonna be 60 pieces altogether. And after that I can plant something for free smelters, or maybe it's just two, and free constructors. So like this, I wanna do not wanna overlap here. Yeah. What I am missing? Of course, the energy. Where are you? Okay. And it's already producing. Let's clear this site too. And I think the steel beams will be ready by the time I am finished with this other production thing. Energy comes here, connected. This one. Oh, I'm missing the iron plates. But the good thing is here we have a lot of them. So let's just take them. Come here. Let's put a merger here. Gonna be deconstructed. Merger. Yep. Are we receiving the copper? I do not see anything coming from that side. Yeah, it's coming. Okay. And the merger will go up there. But how I will climb up there? Probably I will have to put a ladder into here. Let's check if I fall down. Yeah. That's not good. Let's try it once more. Now it's okay. And where to place the things that we need. I need two smelters, right? Production smelter. Feed it from this side, maybe. Yeah. So feed it from the back. These gonna produce. Yeah, 30 pieces. Okay, let's put a splitter here, which is going to be fed from this side. There we go. And finished product come here. I will need two constructors. No, it was three constructors, and I need reinforced iron plates. So let's get those reinforced iron plates, and in the meantime just check these. Oh yeah, just as I told, they are ready. Let's feed them here and launch.
Milestone reached. Blueprints reduce repetitive building tasks, further optimizing your progression towards saving Earth with its beautiful ecosystems, abundant natural resources, and sunsets over frolicking puppies and kittens. The blueprint designer allows you to build and combine structures once and then duplicate that configuration effortlessly. Any complaints about the spatial restrictions will only reveal your own inefficiencies.
I have something else in mind. In the meantime, I'm gonna deconstruct these things and probably we'll put the smelters totally in this back area because I need only two. Production smelter, and yeah, like that. that. Okay, and other one here, and I'm gonna put the splitter into this side like this. That was not good. Yeah. And I'm gonna feed these things from here, or maybe like this. So feed from there, and product goes here. That's good. And now connect. You are being connected to here. And right there, now I can jump. Okay, these things should work now. There we go. Okay, so constructors, I need 3 of them. And the question is how I should position these things. Maybe like this. Yeah, I like this idea. 1, 2, 3. So finished products from here. It's gonna be a merger going that direction, right? This one, yeah. Connect those, and I need a splitter into here. Like this, yeah. Okay, and this one into here, this one into here. Well, that's an efficient way to connect these things together. And the finished product, oh yeah, we do not have energy, that's the problem. I was checking why we are standing. Maybe put that a little bit further away. Yeah, connect that one there, that one in there, come on, okay, under electricity shock, there you go. And I need one more pole into here, energy for that one, energy there, and energy to that one. Okay, now I just have to set these constructors into some copper sheet. There we go, and there, and collect the finished products, merge. Okay, like this, that's it. Okay, and conveyor belt. And I should store the finished products maybe in this container. Yep, it's done. And there we go. Copper sheets on the way. That's pretty good. We have a nice big area here that is ready for anything else useful. Wow, look at those pipes. A lot of pieces already. We are producing very fast. So what's the next thing? I suppose it's this logistics MK3 with the conveyor belt MK3. It's really good. Let's just select this milestone. And I have to put reinforced iron plates into there. I am not sure if I have those reinforced iron plates ready, but maybe yes. Put the iron plates in. Take these things out. Yeah, this one as well. There are a lot of sources, a lot of things in my inventory already. I'm struggling a little bit with the inventory management. But I will give a little bit of consideration for that. And after that, that's gonna be solved. Yeah, iron plate. What else? I do not want to put the rotors down. Let's check things here. Rotors, okay. Reinforced iron plates, okay. What's the situation in here? Very good. Let's go upstairs. I am missing... oops. Wrong move, wrong step. I am missing the beams. The steel beams. Are they in here? Yeah. So let's check what's the situation in here. 2, 3. Whoa, that's good. I am only missing 22 iron beams. Much better than I expected. Steel beams, and I can create a couple of those. Yeah, I think if I go up and come down, it's basically it's done. And you need copper ingots here. Put those in. Oh, because yeah, I know why. Wrong move. This should be creating steel beams. Yeah. That's right. And now it's ready.
Milestone reached. Improved storage containers and the conveyor belt Mark III provide the obviously necessary tools for improving your current setup. Production speed is of the essence after all. So work hard. Work as if every person you have ever or will ever love is depending solely on the choices that you make. Because they are. Warning. Fix-it psychologists recommend not dwelling on the crushing mental and physical strain of your responsibilities and simply continuing to be productive. Hard work has repeatedly proven to be the best cure for any kind of stress. Now back to work.
Okay, I like these texts. Really funny sometimes. So, advanced steel production. This is the next thing I would like to unlock. Yeah, we are going step by step. That's the easiest way. Oh, and I cannot feed it because the shuttle has not came back. So what's next, you may ask, and I have something in mind. Let's store all in there. I'm gonna take this, this. Okay, nothing else from here. And the cables, this one. I think I had some biofuel on me. Where are you? Nowhere to be found. Come on. Oh, there you go. Okay, so I can build pole, I can not build cables, take the cable. So what's the next plan? There is a storage in there that requires electricity connected, and I think that is what I'm gonna do. And just before that I start and go there, I would like to check this electricity production system we have in here. Normally it's working good, but yeah, just as I thought, the quantity of resources is low, and the reason for that, wood is working fine. Yeah, no leaves at all. So this means I have to gather wood and leaves, which I will just do now, and hopefully I will find and unlock some new things during the process. So let's check this constructor here. I had some limestone on hand. Take the electricity with me. And I hope my electricity production is just enough to be able to handle this situation with the storage. Okay, let's put this pole here. Take it further. Oh, we are being attacked. That's not good. Absolutely not good. Come on. Okay, he's down. There were some raw quartz in here. I'm gonna gather it. Some food, and I'm gonna harvest the Visalia as well. There's another enemy. Let's just talk with him a little bit. There you go. I cannot gather his remains. This means clearing time. Yeah. Did I gather it? It's the spit. Yeah. I have picked it up without any intention. Okay, so electricity, and yeah, it's connecting, it's good. There is no system shutdown, which is also good. So let's open this thing here, and I'm gonna run away very fast because the poisonous plants are very harmful. I do not want to try them once again, what they can do. Deconstructed. Okay, this one I have harvested. And what, which way to go? There is something. Like, it's the blue orb, right? Yeah. So it seems.
Your waves lap at our shores. When will you land?
Let's see if I can collect it.
The effigy has no song, only echoes, but it is part of a river. Why does the effigy avoid the windows?
Attention. Your brain's operations are outside typical parameters, Time spent daydreaming will be deducted from your sustenance budget.
Okay. There's a power slug in here. Let's just collect it. Yeah, I like to explore things. And there is another enemy. Let's fight face to face. And there are a couple of trees in there. I'm gonna check them very shortly. What's that? Some enemies, okay. Enemies I can fight. And is that a yellow power slug? Oh, that's good. New resource. Okay, enemies down. And the yellow power slug. Right, that is. Okay, I think it's time to harvest some trees and branches. There you go. So yeah, once again, developers made a really good job with this feature. I mean, it's much faster, much easier. It has area clear, which is very good. I like it very much. You are gathering the required resources in no time. However, coal is unlocked, and this means sooner or later, I suppose sooner, I will just produce the required energy from coal power, which is self-sustainable in terms of resources, so I will gather the coal. Oh, another enemy. This one is bigger, right? But not harder. So, getting back to coal, yeah, I will create all the energy requirement from coal for now, and that's gonna be much easier, faster. And I do not have to collect things once again. This means if I go and explore, I do not have to fill my inventory with leaves and wood. Oh, and we have something here.
Potential edible collected. Reminder that look and smell alone do not provide sufficient data to determine exact risk of consumption. Just because it looks like you can eat it does not mean it won't eat you. Research it in the MAM to establish classification and potential application.
Okay, we have a very nice place in here. What's the other resource? Let's just check it really fast. So iron is here, in there, and it's not iron on that position. No, not iron. Come on. I want to check if it's copper. Yeah, so copper there, iron there, iron there, and limestone in there. That's good. I'm gonna mark this location. Yeah, that's a point of interest in here, and I'm gonna remove this stamp because it's been solved. So that's a good place. I mean, I will definitely create some mines in there. And what's this? Basically, it's nothing at the moment. I suppose I can blow this up a little bit later, because it's a different shape rock than the other ones, as you can see. So I just marked it. Coal is not really interesting. My inventory is also full. And is that another resource or just a strange place? Whatever, we will check it later. So let's go back to the hop. What's this? Bauxite. Yeah. Can I drop something? Yeah, limestone is not interesting just for now. Let's mine this. I'm not sure. Probably we will be able to create aluminium out of this, but not just yet. Let's gather it for a possible later use. And going back to the hub, another limestone in here. Do I wanna mark it? Maybe yes. Let's put this. Can I take that mycelia? No. It's too deep in the water. The harmful plants. Okay, I think it's just going back to the hub. That's the only thing I would like to do now. Run back there, and I'm gonna try to fulfill the requirements for the next milestone. Yeah, that's a good idea, I think. Oh, they are not hindering me from running. Some extra move. We are in the future anyway, so just if I would just stand there, I would have been transported to the proper location. Oh, and yeah, feeding the biomass production line. That was I was going for. So let's sort things out. Put the leaves there. Like that. And also the wood goes in there. Now I feel secure regarding energy production. That's good. There's a sulfur, let's just gather it. Okay, and I'm gonna collect the modular frames which are produced by this time. Probably it's not that much, but more than nothing. Yep. One more, okay. And let's gather the things from the storage. Modular frames, I'm gonna take maybe all. Let's sort things out there. There you go. These ones are coming with me. What is left there? Okay, it can stay there. Everything's fine. Let's just fulfill this request. Couple of modular frames, rotors. I need concrete, and I need more steel pipes, right? It's on the second floor. I will just go there very fast. Take a couple of pieces. Hop, hop, hop. Right. And they are in there. Whoa, lot of pieces. I'm gonna collect them. I will need only 100 pieces for now. But this thing is not doing anything at the moment. Let's just put a couple of pieces in there. And maybe a full stack of cables, why not? And let's put some iron plates too. Yeah, that seems to be right. Okay, hop here, hop there. That's okay. arrive to the hub. There you go, and I'm missing the modular frames only. But I think I have a couple of things here, right? The hard drive, let's do that. And these one, no, this one's not possible, no. Visalia, it's not done. We have this. Let's. Oh, I cannot research it because hard drives underprocessed. Let's then store things here for now. We will do it a little bit later. That one, that one. Oh yeah, the silica. It's a copper ore. Okay, that's it. I'm gonna check the modular frames once more. Six pieces. I think I'm gonna make the rest of the modular frames by hand. I can create 10 pieces. I mean, yeah, probably just 10 pieces. I will need reinforced iron plates to do the rest. I think I'm gonna do that before ending this episode because, yeah, then I can look for a new milestone. I need reinforced iron plates, right? Nothing here, nothing in here. Let's collect them from here. Yeah, that's right. So I need 31 pieces of these. And I have 16 on hand. So this means I need just produce 16 pieces. That's 8 times going through the line. It's not a big time investment. 26, just a couple of more pieces and we are okay. And here we go, that's it. To launch.
Milestone reached. The Miner Mark II allows extraction of resources from nature to fix it at twice the speed of the Mark I model. Miners can be directly upgraded to Mark II without removing the Mark I model, just like conveyor belts and other upgradable infrastructure. Unfortunately, setting up the production of advanced steel parts and project part number 3, automated wiring, will not be as easy. Every moment you delay reduces the chances of saving humanity. I will not show you the predictions, it would only demotivate you.
Okay, that's funny. And so, that's the next thing I would like to unlock, or maybe the hyper tubes. But at the moment it seems there is not much left that I can unlock. And so this means in the next episode I would like to concentrate on creating the space elevator requirements, and I will have to find out how to do that. So that's all about this episode, guys. Thank you for watching and I hope you enjoyed this episode, and hopefully we will meet each other in the next one. Goodbye.